Teachers for America presents a Bible class on the fundamental basics for victorious Christian living. Establish a strong foundation for conquering the trials and temptations of daily life. Increase your faith and learn to use the powerful weapons of spiritual warfare as you listen to Christian Living 101 with Pastor Gene Applegate.
Good morning, everyone. We welcome you to Christian Living 101. I want to talk to you about the value of drawing near unto the Lord and to the Heavenly Father. I think all of us realize that as Christians, we serve the Lord, we want to be close to Him, and yet if you're like so many, and sometimes I've had this experience myself, we find ourselves going into a situation where God seems to be a long way from us. We pray and our prayers aren't answered, and we come before the Lord in supplication and talk to Him and tell Him what we want and how we desire this or we desire that, and we find ourselves sort of in a zone wherein there's nothing happening in our lives and the presence of God's Spirit seems to be a long ways away. Well, you hear us talking often about the covenant promises of God, and we often think of those as the Ten Commandments and the various promises in the Old Testament, and then the basic covenant of God wherein we receive salvation and redemption through the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ by obeying the scripture that Peter gave us in Acts 2:38, wherein he says, repent and be baptized for the remission of sin in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will receive the Holy Spirit. Well, it's important, I think, for us to take this a little bit deeper than that. And this, likewise, is a covenant promise of God. The promise is, and I quote, if you draw near to God, God will draw near to you. Now, it's just that simple. And you say, but Pastor, I love the Lord. I've been converted. I've been redeemed. I know where I stand in the things of God. And I'm perfectly familiar with the fact that I've been made a new creature in Jesus Christ. I know my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life in heaven. I know all is well within my life, and yet I feel so far from God, and He isn't very close to me at times. Well, let me give you a few little secrets that will help. First of all, we need to recognize that drawing near to God has more to do with our spiritual and our emotional and mental attitude towards God and towards His kingdom than what we may realize. So often we come to the Lord and we voice or give lip service, if you please, unto God by offering prayer, even by praising the Lord sometimes in sort of a shallow way. But it's a lip service. It doesn't come from the heart. And you say, well, how can I get to that place where I know how to draw into the very throne room of God and stand there before Him in His presence and know that my Lord Jesus Christ, my mediator, my advocate, is there with me, and I can have that intimate relationship with the Lord and with my Heavenly Father? Well, I'll share with you some basic elements that we need to learn about. The first thing we must know is that in order for there to be a relationship, there must be communication. Now, God communicates with us in two ways, sometimes more than that, but two predominant measures. The first is by His Word. The second is through the working of His Holy Spirit in our spirit and in our life. And so we need to cultivate that communication with the Heavenly Father by taking advantage of these particular lines of communication and fellowship that we have because of the redemptive work of Jesus at the cross of Calvary. So what do I do? Well, the first thing, never neglect reading the Word. The Word of God is God's communication to His people. You need to realize that as sons and daughters of God, we stand before God God, and we have been given a language of communication wherein God can communicate to us, and indeed we can receive that communication and communicate back unto Him. And by reading the Word of God, which is the language, the message, the vision, the foundational truths of God and what He expects of His people, then we can begin to understand how to draw near unto Him. You say, well, Pastor Applegate, how can that possibly be? I read the Word occasionally. I read the Word at least once a week. Well, let me share with you, it needs to be more often than that. Do you talk to your wife just once a week? Some of you, I suppose, don't have much communication at all between each other. But that's another subject. But the point is, do you talk to those that you love and your friends that are very close to you? Do you talk to them just on occasion? I think not. As often as you can, you get together for fellowship, and you have that time of exchange and inter-exchange with your thoughts and ideas and with what's on your heart and your mind and what you want to decide to talk about or decide to do that particular day. And so the communication is there. The same is true of the Lord. Now, a lot of people believe that the Bible was written to sinners, that it was given to the heathen, so to speak, they could come to the Lord, be converted, and saved or redeemed according to their particular situation, and therefore it was a Bible given to sinners. It was a message to them. Not true. It gives instruction to the believer about reaching the sinner, and it also gives instruction to the believer about how to live their own life. But the Bible was written to God's people, to the believer, to the man, woman of faith, to those who desire to live according to the concepts and precepts and covenant promises of God, and it was given to we Christians, and it is our avenue of communication, if you please, unto the Father. So read the Word daily, read the Word more often than daily if you have the opportunity, if you can take the opportunity, and you should, but at least daily. And if you can only read a few scriptures, it's important, because the Holy Spirit, which is the second line of communication that we have with the Heavenly Father, takes the Word that we read. He magnifies and increases our understanding so that we can receive the full message that is in there for us, and causes that Word to be quickened unto our spirit and stored within the concepts of our life, and thereby we are able to walk in obedience to the desires, the vision, the plan, the directives of God the Father and our Lord and Savior, Redeemer, the Lord Jesus Christ. And so it's a very simple thing for us to understand, I think, that by the Word and by the Spirit we communicate with the Heavenly Father. Now, to do that, we need to have the right attitude. I don't know how many times you've had an experience wherein you're talking to someone and the words that come forth sound very, very nice and very friendly, even uplifting and encouraging, but then when you look at the expression on their face or the body language, you realize that it's given in sarcasm, and the attitude that they have about it is totally wrong, and they are not in any way trying to lift you up, but the words lose their meaning in the expression and the attitude with which they are delivered. The same is true as we come unto God. If we come unto God with an open heart, with a yearning spirit to have fellowship and communion with Him, if we desire for Him to be the real leader in our life and to be the most important and the ultimate element of authority within our daily living, then we're going to have an attitude wherein when we come to the Lord, either through reading the Word or hearing from the Holy Spirit or going to the Lord in prayer, we're going to have the right attitude, we're going to have that sincere desire and hunger for a relationship with God. Now, God does not force Himself upon anyone. He will, in answer to the prayers of His saints, cause people to come to a place where they feel like that they have to respond because of the pressure that they feel from the conviction of the Holy Spirit. But we need to recognize that that's the result of the prayers of the saints in behalf of one who is either in need, maybe a fellow brother or sister,